Hey folks, this week we're going to be talking about forces and friction. And we're going to do lab a little bit differently than we have in the past. This week, the whole first half of the lab are going to be experiments designed by you yourself. What we've got for you is an overall goal. Your goal for the first half of the lab is to try to figure out what is the coefficient of friction of this rubber side of the surface with your desktop. Now, it's completely up to you how you do this, but you need to make two measurements of the static coefficient of friction and two measurements of the kinetic coefficient of friction. We're not going to tell you how to do it, but we do want you in this case to keep track of the uncertainty propagation throughout all of your measurements. If, for example, you're going to be measuring distances with your meter stick, we're going to need to care about exactly how accurate are you making measurements on the millimeter scale here. The block itself is tied to a string and has a loop right up close and a loop far away. If you're using the distance one, you might end up hanging some masses over the end of your desk across a pulley. Now, if you're doing that, then the tricky thing that you need to care about here is how accurate are your masses. The masses themselves I can take as perfectly accurate. This one is 100 grams. It's pretty much 100 grams. But if I'm trying to find the point at which the block breaks free or which it slides at a constant velocity, I'm limited by how much mass can I add? What's the smallest increment there? Conversely, if you choose to go electronically here, we've got a couple different things for you to work with. We've got timers, where A, we have the accuracy of the timer itself and also your own reaction time. We've got force probes, and we also have the sonic rangers that you've used before. Now, the catch here, though, is if you're using these two sensors, you're going to want to try to get your data from the computers, either fitting a line or trying to find an average value. So you'll either be working with the root mean square error of the line of your slope, maybe some correlation with that line slope, or you might be using a standard deviation on there. And it's up to you to make sure that you accurately propagate through all of that uncertainty. Once you're done with that set of activities, we're going to go ahead and jump into a stations format for you, where we have a whole bunch of different stations, some old ones that you may have seen over the last week, some new ones for you too. Let's go ahead and take a look at a few of them. From last week, you might not have gotten to this, but we can take a look at some other friction-y type forces, like the drag force, for example, where if this is falling at a constant velocity, constant speed, then all of the energy transformations that are taking place are converting whatever type of energy you have into thermal energy, the motion of the air, all right? And so we're gonna ask you again a scaling problem. What happens if we increase the mass of the filters? Just like last week, we'll go ahead and give you a chance to take the giant exercise ball and a high-speed camera out to the oval in order to kick the ball and measure the drag force acting on that. Now we can go back to friction all by itself. We've got these friction blocks here, and a fun way to calculate the coefficient of friction between this block and this board that I've got is to try to tilt the board as steep as you can get until the block just starts to slide. Once it's sliding, we can use that angle to calculate either kinetic coefficient of friction or static coefficient of friction, depending on the angle you're working with. And if you didn't get a chance last week, we'll let you take a chance at this week, where we want you to calculate what is the coefficient of friction between the textbook and a tabletop using only the sonic ranger. It's a nice good puzzle for you folks. Another station that we'll have out, which can vary a little bit year to year depending on the equipment we have, is all about magnetic braking, where if you move a magnet past a piece of conductive metal, it actually generates electricity in that metal. That electricity heats up the metal, and so again, all of that energy, the kinetic energy, gravitational potential energy, is converted into thermal through another interesting process. Your task there is going to be trying to figure out exactly how does that force, the eddy currents, how do they depend on the velocity of the vehicle? So lots of different activities. Again, the first half of the lab is completely designed by you. Make sure you tell us what you're doing, how accurate you are, propagate through that uncertainty, and it's going to be fantastic. Then we break into stations and should have a fun time. See you next week.